What's up, scavengers? And Scandinavia here. In today's video, we're going to upgrade my Messer by Burr setup a ton, so stick around. Before we do that, however, I would like to thank you all for the immense support that I have gotten, and the fact that we have passed 7,000 subscribers is so awesome. As you may or may not know, I did a huge treasure hunt for when we hit 5,000 subscribers, and I am planning to do one even larger at 10k. So why not subscribe now to not miss out and be a part of the Scandinavian scavengers? Okay, enough with the self-promotion, let's get into the real video. So, my plan was to have a super long tube that spans across my entire animal room, leading to a wall-mounted nest. But first, I had to make a holder for the wall-mounted nest. It's just a basic bent metal screwed into the wall with a little padding so the nest don't crack. Talking about the nest, here it is. The largest nest I have ever made, actually, and I am super happy about it. It's in Whitetongue with a glass panel screwed into the nest, therefore removable if needed. By the way, if you want a video tutorial on how to make a similar nest, tell me in this poll right here. Thank you. So, after removing the screws, we are able to insert it into the holder, and then screw them back on. How do you like the nest? I love how it turned out. A bit too spacious on the top right, but that was because a wall there cracked and I had to remove it. But otherwise, I love it. There are three entrances, one that will connect the long tube and two others for future expansions, if that ever is needed. Now let's get going with making the huge tube between their old setup and the new nests. I placed out cable holders across two floors on my animal shelf, spacing them out around 7 decimeters or so apart. When that was done, I placed in the tubing. I then clamped together the holders tight around the tube so that they will hold it steady. The ant's old nest was on one floor lower than the new nest, so I had to make a spiral staircase for them. Messer ants are very bad at climbing, so I couldn't have a tube going straight up, but instead had to make a very slight incline instead. So I then wrapped the tube around the shaft and then fastened it behind with tube holders on every turn. I did not record that, however, since it was hard enough to do it without recording it. But after some time, I finally got the spiraling staircase that I wanted. Awesome. Now, it was time to build the new outworld, since they really needed a new one. Messer ants have a tendency to wipe their fecals across some surface, making the waste spots very dirty up against the glass. But now, let's make the new outworld. First of all, I cleaned the glass aquarium a little. And after that, it was time to make the lid. The goal of the lid was to have a lip all around the edge of the outworld. Then having a barrier of olive oil upside down, so that it would be impossible to escape. Taking a ton of inspiration from Ants Australia's design on their awesome outworld, I decided to make a very similar lid to my new one. I can't stress enough how freaking awesome Ants Australia's products are, especially their outworlds. However, I wanted a much larger outworld than what you could buy from them, so I had to make one myself. I did not record me doing that either, since I mostly just experimented with how to do it, but in the end result it was this. A shitty, thin, wobbly, scraped sliding door mechanism. I mean, it looks horrible, but it works, so I was pleased with it. Now, applying acrylic to something can be hard sometimes, especially silicone acrylic. Since acrylic is a plastic, aquarium silicone does not get a good grip on it. Therefore, you have to use a primer on the plexiglass, on the spots that you want to silicone. I used this primer called Sika Multiprimer Marine. If you ever want to silicone acrylic, using a primer like this is a must if you want it to work. However, this stuff is very toxic and pretty dangerous, so please have parental guidance if you're going to attempt using this. When you do, you just apply it onto a cloth like this, and wipe down the surface where you are going to silicone, the edges in most cases. And it should work. Good luck! Before I silicone the lid and lip onto the outworld, however, I drilled a hole in the glass and inserted this, an electrical cable holder. I don't really know the name of this, but it is used to secure and waterproof electrical cables and such. And awesome for holding ant tubing. And boom, all ready to be decorated. So, first I chose to add some red sand. A random spider fell down into the aquarium and I honestly thought that it had come from inside the jar. But it seems like it just hitched a ride from the shelf, I guess. Anyhow, with the sand added, it was time for the scape. So I really tried a ton of different ways to decorate. I tried large, small, round, flat, rocks, and a ton of different sticks. I tried seed husks, grass stuff, and yeah, basically everything. But finally, I settled for this scape. Pretty neat. Why I chose this layout was since it used the height of the tank, since I personally don't like having large empty spaces in setups like this. And since these sticks made good use of that space, I chose this layout. So I brushed off the last sand on the rocks, applied some olive oil onto the lip, and it was go time. I decided the best way to approach connecting their old setup would be here, since it was a good spot for both traffic flow and aesthetically looked okay. So I inserted a T connector into the new tube, and then went on ahead cutting open the old tube. When I did this, I did hesitate a bit, so some ants sadly got a bit crushed. But with the tube cut up, and one being sealed up with cotton, just a few five workers or so managed to escape. And again, messer are super easy to catch, so it was really nothing. And there we had it! The setups were now connected, and it was super exciting, finally giving these guys a new home. But now all that was left to do was to wait. Wait some more. I waited for like a good hour or so until one finally scaled the spiral stair. Okay, maybe the next one. Well, it took much longer than expected for them to just reach the top part of the spiraling staircase, about 2 hours or so. In the meantime, however, they had already discovered the new outworld pretty instantaneous, and was working hard to map it out. I gave them some honey, but they didn't seem so interested at all, actually. But then, whilst feeding them honey, I noticed it. The first worker was attempting to reach the new nest! She turned back after 3 seconds though, but they were on their way. The next worker came and she almost reached the wall, but then she turned back in the last second. She was heading back when she realized how far she'd come and changed her mind. She was going for it. With her mind set on the prize, she crossed her own old record by a whole 2 centimeters. Incredible. Let's watch that in instant replay. Wow. About a minute later, however, another worker came and threw the old record out the window by actually entering the nest without hesitation. She inspected it a bit and then headed back to tell the others of her incredible find. Half an hour later, 7 ants were in the nest and they had brought gifts. Trash. Awesome. I decided to water the nest some more and also decided not to peek inside the new nest for a day or two. I took the cover off of the old nest to encourage the move, and waited. I left the situation like that basically for a week actually, without any success. You guys on Instagram were saying that they loved heat, and that I should heat the nest. So that's what I did, I added a heat mat behind, and it worked. More ants moved, even with some brood. Which was very good news, but not the entire colony moved. Since this was spread out over the course of several weeks, I didn't record me doing anything. But I kept on watering the nest and had the heating mat behind it. After around a month of waiting, however, they had finally moved. Yes. And guess who decided to show herself? The queen. I hadn't actually seen her since I first started the moving process, so seeing her alive and well was a relief for sure. With the majority of ants, and most importantly, the queen, moved, I decided it was time to disconnect the old setup. First, I removed the fan that I had placed above the old outworld in order to create airflow inside the tubing for them not to nest in there, as I had some issues of them nesting actually inside of the tubing since it was so long and created high humidity. So, disconnecting the T-connector from the old setup, it was ready to be carried to the table. We decided to divide the setup some more in order to control the collection of ants better. And check this out, this is the T-connector that I used to connect the old setup to the new one. Just after 1 month of biting on it, they had gotten this far. Damn, the messaginess are not to be taken lightly. Cleaning up the outworld went smoothly. removing as large pieces as possible before moving all the ants. After the outworld, it was time for the nest. I removed them and the seed storages, and that was that. After all the workers was collected, they were dumped into the new outworld, alongside with their previous seed stash. Talking about seeds, do you guys know where I can get large quantities of seeds that Messer eats? I have tried tons of different seeds that I can find in stores and in the wild, like this ball of seeds that I found, but they don't really seem interested at all in that compared to the level of excitement they show when giving these types of seeds. If you could name any of these seeds that they seem to love, or know where I can get large quantities cheaply, I would be grateful if you can send a DM to me on Instagram, ants_Scandinavia. Thank you. Quick side note, long tubes like this can cause issues, since it holds humidity rather well, and the ants may be prone to nesting inside the tubing, as might have done. But now I have actually added tube connectors with glued on metal meshing on 4 spots in the 10 meter tube to create some airflow inside the tubing and avoid high humidity, although I have not recorded that. And if you want to know more, check out my Instagram since I posted about it there. Well, that was it for this time. Hope you enjoyed this rather huge setup build for my Messer colony, and hopefully they will thrive in this new nest and grow fast to become a huge colony. Can't wait. Until next time, have a good one, Scavs. Bye!